It's about to go down!
Uh-huh.
Yeah.
All right.
Yo, listen up. Here's a story about Cranmer. It's got some info about some of the characters.
Listen!
But Cranmer's the one behind the scenes.
What?
He's really important for you and me. So listen up for all the deeds. Get out of your seats is the word on the street. King Henry broke England away from the Pope to divorce Miss Catherine and not elope. Cranmer was behind this all, you see, all because of her failed pregnancy. This led to the act of supremacy. The king made Cranmer Archbishop of Canterbury.
Money.
England was still quite Catholic, but the break with Rome was fantastic. Cranmer brought in the English Bible. The Christian faith became more reliable. After Henry, Edward became prominent. The church began to become more Protestant. Cranmer.
Yeah, yeah.
Without him,
we'd be Roman Catholic.
Yeah, 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 yeah.
Yeah, so Cranmer wrote some injunctions. He did this to fix Catholic malfunctions. He was so sick of their dysfunctions. So out went Thomas More. His theology was so poor. Out went the monasteries and he came in new policies. And out went the images to change all the villages. Out went the sacraments to avoid further accidents. And in came the Bible. In came the homilies and in came the prayer book. Gobbledygook, come take a new look at the Protestant England, yo.
Cranmer,
yeah, yeah.
Without him, we'd be Roman Catholic.
Ooh,
yeah, yeah.
Next, Cranmer wrote the 42. Without them, the church would have no clue.
No clue.
They outlined what they believed. Catholics were grieved, but Protestants were relieved. They later became the 39. This awesome article is still quite fine. The Catholics let out a whine. Kind of out of line, but it was a sign that England was Protestant for the first time. Woo. Let's hear it for Cranmer. Let's hear him rhyme.
Yeah,
Cranmer. Yeah, yeah. Without him, we'd be Roman Catholic. Yeah, yeah.
So I'm accused of being a heretic, but all of this is really quite pathetic. So now I have to be all apologetic, otherwise they'll stop making my heart tick. My boy Edward is now hanging with Jesus. He put all of his faith in his death for us. But Mary took the throne, which doesn't please us, cause our theory of salvation suffers from incompleteness. So my brothers that are bishops are getting kicked out of their parishes by Mary. Now that is no doubt, cause they're against mass day in and day out. And it's covered is that Mary and I had a falling out. The story of Mary's reign is quite a thriller. No one would say it, but she's a serial killer. Now I'm at the tower with Latimer and Ridley. Mary found it funny to burn them right in front of me. Now I'm gonna pledge allegiance to the Pope and drink Jesus' blood, though it tastes like soap.
Soap!
Cranmer.
Yeah, yeah.
Without him,
we'd be Roman Catholic.
Yeah, yeah.
Justification by faith is the only way to heaven. Transubstantiation's a joke, bread's not even unleavened. As for the Pope, man, he's like 111. The only one who deserves glory is number 7. Now it's time for my final sermon. They think I'm gonna preach on everything I've learned. The Catholic Church is a fallacy. Saved by works, not son, it's grace and mercy. Now I'm taken to where my boys, Latimer and Ridley, are burnt at the stake on their way to eschatology. So now it's getting pretty hot all around me right now. Burnt my hands for writing things I disavow. Reach my end looking to the sky with a sly nod, because I will be with Jesus at the right hand of God.
Grandma. Yeah, yeah.
Without him, we'd be Roman Catholic.
Yeah, yeah.
Yo, now it's time for contemporary relevance. The Catholics, they would have taken offense. But without Cranmer, we would be heretics. Without Cranmer, we'd be Roman Catholic.
Cranmer. Yeah, yeah. Without him, we'd be Roman Catholic. Yeah, yeah.